Professor, a few days ago we talked about resistance and heat in electricity. But what if we remove that resistance?
Well, that's a very good question. If we could have something with no resistance, then we could send an electric current through it and there'd be no heat produced. And in some cases, that would be very useful because we could send currents around without wasting any energy on heating the wires.
How do we do this?
Well, it turns out that's possible. There are materials called superconductors. They're materials which, if cooled enough, suddenly lose all their resistance. And then we can send a current through them, no heating occurs, and if we start a current in them, it'll just go on and on forever, or until the thing stops being a superconductor.
Is it possible to demonstrate this?
Yes, indeed. We've got a superconductor here, at least a material that will become superconducting when we cool it off enough. So let's cool it off by pouring some liquid nitrogen over it. That'll take a little while. The liquid nitrogen is boiling now, but it'll eventually cool everything off and it'll stop boiling. Now, what I'm going to do, Larry, is lower this tiny magnet down over the superconductor. Now, as the magnet comes down, it'll generate a current, like our generators 2 days ago, in the superconductor. And the current will produce a magnet which will hold the original magnet up. Yes. Why don't you try passing a piece of paper underneath, Larry, just to check that it really is levitated?
Just to prove it. Here we go. Okay. Oh, it's fascinating, but what's the practical use of this levitation?
Well, surprisingly enough, one can imagine uses. One could imagine trains which rode over superconducting tracks and were actually levitated that way, and then, of course, there'd be no friction, so they'd just go coasting along very smoothly and easily.